So, you know, succinctly, what is Cardano? It's basically a framework to give people economic identity. We termed that a FOSS, a financial operating system. And under the hood, it has to have a bunch of protocols for value, identity, and governance. And then it's self-evolving. So basically, you can use this to issue stocks and bonds and commodities and currencies and utility tokens. You can use this to identify your people and do KYC and AML in your people or build reputation metrics and so forth. And you can use this to actually decide who pays and who's in control. And because anything in finance requires a regulatory layer or a decision layer or a governance layer. And if you go from a national to a transnational view, and you go from public to private, you need to replace the pre-existing governance structures with something else. You know, it's kind of a roll-up of a lot of the concepts and ideas that have come out of the peer-to-peer foundation and ideas that have come out of the cryptocurrency space. And we said, let's just go for gold. Let's put a collection of protocols all into one stack, call it a financial operating system, and then say, well, what can you build then on something like that? And that's usually how you understand these things. Like people say, oh, I have a smartphone. It's like, well, what does that really mean? You say, well, let me show you Google Maps. You say, oh, okay. Now I kind of get an idea of what a smartphone does. And the more apps you see, the more clarity you get about what this concept is, a smartphone. Similarly, you say, what's a FOSS? You say, well, the more utilities that you see it runs, the more ideas you get. So for example, we're looking at things like supply chain systems, so we can track and trace agricultural goods. We're looking at voting systems. We're looking at credential management systems, so you can authenticate if they have college degrees or not. And we're also looking at financial applications as well. Like there's a whole bunch of DeFi things that are going to come, like stable coins and oracles and DEXs. But the general idea is that the system should be able to be an end-to-end stack for economic identity. So what that means is that if some person enters the system, they should be able to have some place to place their data and their identity to build a reputation. They should have some way of getting credit. They should have some way of interfacing with a currency that's reasonably stable that they can send to anybody in the world. They should have the ability to interface with exchanges. If they have a business, they should have the ability to securitize that business. They have banking services, insurance services, credit services, remittance services, but then it also includes a governance stack. So if they, for example, want to do shareholder votes with a governance layer, well, they can reuse the Voltaire system, right? And then suddenly now they can do shareholder votes with the system. This is kind of the vision of it, is that it's a one-stop shop. And then once you're in it, you don't have to leave it. And it will do more and more and more and more of your financial life and your economic life. And it gives you identity, identity that a government can't take from, identity that's not revocable, identity that you can't lose. There's ways to recover and restore that. And that's what we've been working on for the last 5 years. You know, we've written more than 75 papers, a million lines of code, and we've launched now two generations of the product, Myron and Shelley. And every time we launch a generation, it gets more capabilities and features. And we're just entering the Voltaire era and soon the Dogen era. So we'll get smart contracts and voting. And then basically the system self-evolves so that it can capture more and more and more of that economic life and also get more and more users. The other hallmark of Cardano is that we designed it so that the system will scale with the needs of its users. So one day we wake up and let's say we're fortunate enough to have a billion people in the system can actually sustain and handle that, whereas current cryptocurrencies can't do that.